All right, everyone, how's it going? Welcome. It is officially 2020 in Hawkeye Pro Wrestling. We start a brand new year and a whole lot of things changing. Well, maybe not changing, but we've you know, just some minor changes as well as, you know, some additions. I'll plug real quick in just a couple of weeks, less than 2 weeks. Sorry, that fast food's coming back at me. Once again, in just under 2 weeks, Infamous 47, the aftermath from what happened at the Doi Darts Holiday Special. We'll get that. Starting off, we will have the fight finally come to life. MMA hybrid rules. We'll see that training come into. We'll see how well that training has worked out for Prince Devitt as he takes on Katsuyori Shibata. Of course, Devitt has been training for a while now with Bob Sapp, but a bit of a wrench was thrown into this as Shibata was approached and is now, I guess, apparently being trained by Kurt Angle. So we'll see if the Olympic gold medalist can help Shibata out or if Shibata really even needs it. But I feel like the Olympic gold medalist will be an equalizer for Bob Sapp. Of course, through the randomization, Mercedes Martinez had won her Doi Darts throw, and that she will take on Io Shirai for the Hawkeye Pro Women's Championship. Well, I think questions are still arising as to the shape that Io Shirai is in right now. Of course, her and Kana had a drag out brawl for quite a long time that left them both leaving in a stretcher. So it'll be interesting to see what comes of that and if she'll be in the shape to compete. I imagine she will be. She'll have a couple of weeks before that. But, yeah, I think some questions will arise if she'll be 100% ready for Mercedes Martinez, who's been on a roll since her big comeback. And then three-way dance for the Hawkeye Pro Television Championship, Naruki Doi and Sami Sabay challenging Tama Tonga, who's also a bit of a question mark, a little bit less of a question mark because he was able to get the win and not be carried out. However, he's still probably going to be in rough shape after final fight. It's just been a couple of weeks. It'll be just a couple of weeks from then on. And of course, he's got a three-way dance defending against two high caliber athletes in Doi and Sabay. So we will see how that turns out. And of course, once again, the final results of the Doi Darts, the 10-man battle royal to determine the number one contender to the Hawkeye Pro Heavyweight Championship. It will be Father Kingston, Alex Shelley, Kushida, Eddie Edwards, Tama Tonga, Robert Roode, Shinsuke Nakamura, Doc Gallows, Matt Cage, and Katsuyori Shibata. Interesting set of people here, considering you have Tama Tonga and Shibata, who will have matches earlier in the night. So there's a lot of questions going to be arising about just how well this is going to work between these guys, and who could eventually walk away the number one contender to the heavyweight title. Of course, that is at Infamous in just less than 2 weeks. That will be, of course, later on. We won't have to really worry about that on this stream because we are still in week one. So that is what we will be dealing with here. I don't know if people will notice this, but the first bit that you can notice right here is the money. We have less money than we did when I left you. That is because I just spent $1.025 million on the Hawkeye Pro Wrestling Academy. It is the first of the month and first of the year, and so the Hawkeye Pro Wrestling Academy has been built with a 100 reputation, and Breakout's own commissioner, Mick Foley, will be the guy who will be in charge of that. I think a lot of these places generally do general training. Seems like you do shooters and brawling and stuff like that, but I just did general training for that. And Mick Foley being the trainer basically came off the fact that it said, okay, respect, reputation, basics, and psychology. And out of all the people to have for that, you see, let's see, 92, 97, 100, 100. I don't think you can do really any better than that as far as trainers go. So the head trainer for the future of Hawkeye Pro Wrestling is Mick Foley. Will happen. It'll still be a year out. I don't know. Maybe, you know, they say a new TEW isn't coming out in 2019, but who knows? Maybe that'll be it. if we make it another year. There we go. Of course, let's see here. What else did I do? I don't think much else other than the broadcasting. We're officially done with all of our TV stuff. We're now on YouTube. Have that set up, and as you can see, just mediums all the way around. So this is probably going to be something I stick with for quite a while, because I don't think there's an all-encompassing broadcaster like YouTube. So if I'm going to do that with other places, I would pretty much have to make my own broadcaster, because I don't think I can really afford to be in any like big stations. So I think staying a medium right now is probably going to be my wheelhouse. And I'm everywhere in the world, so that's going to help me promote my size and boost up my popularity everywhere. As you can see, a lot of these places could really use that. So we'll see what happens there. Name the first grad after me. Preparations for the Dunn Reynolds session. Man, that was like a year ago, man. I guess I should look at this beforehand. I know this is probably going to be... I don't know if it's like wasting time, but it is interesting. I do want to look at perhaps some of the... Because I didn't really do this at the end of the last one. And that's like the top 100 stuff for last year. So if you look at 2019... Oh, Jesus. The top 10 events were all 2019 stuff. Jesus Christ. When did we actually do... How did we manage to get here at this point? Did we actually have successful events in 2018? I'm trying to... Oh, wait. I'm looking at 2019 the whole way. Jesus. I want to know. When was the biggest 2018 event? Oh, my God. And a random adrenaline. Jesus. So our best one was in 88, 87. You can see here, 2017 was even worse. But 2019, Final Fight, of course, topping it. Festival, right behind it at 97. A Random Adrenaline in July. Damnation had a 94. Grand Prix Final with a 93. Revolution with a 93. So, yeah. Wasting time never. Match-wise, it looks like Match of the Year last year was Shinsuke Nakamura and... Kenny Omega from August. Damn. That actually got rated lower. I don't know if that's by... I'm trying to look here. Because I guess it's... I mean, it's not going by anything specific, it looks like. Because you see with the 99s, there's no rhyme or reason why they are put the way they are. It's not by, like, order of when it happened or anything like that. So I guess Nakamura and... Kenny Omega in their TV title open challenge got one. Tama Nakamura at Anniversary got number two. Tama Nakamura from Final Fight got three. Is it safe to say that Shinsuke Nakamura and Tama Tonga was like the best feud of the year? I have to feel like we can probably safely say that. Yeah, it makes Colt. Yeah, that's a good point. But yeah, I feel like I could be safe to say that Tama Tonga and Shinsuke Nakamura was maybe our best feud. There's American Wolves, Motor City Machine Guns at 4 from Grand Prix Final. Jesus Christ, I forgot how many 99s I had on that show. I had 3 99. Oh no, that's Grand Prix Final, not Final Fight. Nakamura, Tozawa, and Devitt from The Infamous. That was when Nakamura, like, I think that was one of his first matches. Hollister Reynolds at 99, despite how much certain people in my chat hate Shane Hollister. And then Time Splitters, American Wolves from Justice at a 99. And then you finally dip down into the 98s with Mio Shirai and Kana versus Io Shirai and Mayu from Anniversary. Time Splitters, Briscoes, Kings of Wrestling, and the Young Bucks. I think that was Cesaro's last appearance with us. And then Tozawa and Marty Scurll, dude. I think that was Eddie Edwards in a mask for that Hawkeye Pro Grand Prix match. I think we did pretty well attendance-wise, too. Our best one was in North Dakota, 22,000. Final Fight, 21,000. That's about all you really need to look at. Buy rates just kept going up and up and up. So that's good. That Shinsuke guy can work a little. Maybe put him in the world title picture now. I could look into that. I'm trying to remember if there's anything else. No. Okay. I did remove a lot of the morale issues by giving people bonuses, which will be fine. I gave some gimmicks to some of the people who needed them, who just came in, like Hazuki has Black Charisma, which is a character who's cool at being bad, which is kind of what Oedo Tai is. That's basically Kagetsu's like actual thing. But I gave her Lunatic because she seems to do crazy better than, like, cool. So, I could have done Weasel or Wholesome, but Kagetsu and Wholesome don't feel like they go right. And, who else? Kaho. Kaho Kobayashi. She has a Technico. She has a luchador-style baby face, which I think I did because I think she's working in Mexico quite a bit. I think that's the reason why I gave it to her. Either way, we can check real quick on the state of WWE and stuff like that. Let's take a look, just titles and stuff here. Jimmy Uso, the Intercontinental Champion. Jey Uso, the United States Champion. Two women's champs. Sarah Stock, Sarita, Rosa Mendez. Oh my God, they do not give two shits about their women's division. Bray Wyatt, the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, and the tag teams are the Usos. Oh, King of the Midcards, the Usos. Look at the prestige ratings on this shit. Look at the prestige ratings. Ah! Like, your United States title is so far above your Intercontinental title. Jesus. I think the NXT titles are even worse. Let's look. Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic. Jason Jordan, Chad Gable. Two heavyweight titles. Jason Jordan, Brian Kendrick. Two women's, of course. That person. And Jason Jordan, Dana Brooke. And the tag champs are Elias and guy who was created, who came out of the WWE Performance Center. Cool. TNA. I should really just call them Impact Wrestling. Jeff Hardy, of course, there's also two world. Ken Doan, the proper world champ at the 82 mark, so Ken Doan. Marty Bell, Vanessa Craven, neither one of them doing well. Which is a damn shame, because I'm pretty sure Vanessa Craven's actually a pretty damn good wrestler. Marty Bell is not. Manic and Hook Bomberry. Sure. And Mike Bondo, the X Division champ. Jesus Christ, what the fuck is this? New Japan, I'll look at New Japan real quick. I don't think I care enough about Ring of Honor at this point. G1 Climax winner was Naito. Kojima, the heavyweight champion. Is there two of them? Yes, there is. Ibushi, oh, he's the proper champion. Kojima's an 80, but Ibushi is the heavyweight champion. That's where it is. Intercontinental, PJ Black. Okay, that's a thing. Junior heavyweight, Taguchi. Junior tag team, Takashi Minamino. Don't know where he's from. Sure. And Taro Nohashi. Interesting. Sure. Heavyweight tag team, Goto and Kazushi Miyamoto. This is some odd choices, New Japan. It really is. Masada, the never open weight champion. You know what? Even though the prestige is low, that really does make sense. Six-man, never open weight. Oh, there's two of them. God damn it. All right, well. Jay Lethal, Darkness Dragon, and Mascara Dorada. New Japan Cup winner last year was Ada. Super Junior Tag, no, J Cup, World Tag League, Ibushi and Caristico had won that. Never went from Haas to Deathmatch. That's really what just happened there. Mike Mondo, the CZW guy? No, that's Nick Mondo. Mike Mondo was Mikey in the Spirit Squad. And then did some ROH stuff and I think broke his leg on a stage dive spot. Yeah, Nick Mondo retired a long time ago. Pretty much, if you saw that big dive, that big dive off of like that warehouse building with him and Zandig, I think that was the night he retired, because I think he worked like two more matches after that, but he broke a bunch of shit that he didn't want to break. And yeah, he retired that night. I think that was the match when they did the, I think it was through the back of the truck or something. I can't remember, but I'm pretty sure he really fucked himself up. So they were like, yep, okay, yep, done. JWP, okay, Kagetsu has joined. We got a buy. Why are we just now getting the buy rate? That's odd. I love your New Japan save. Nice. Oh, yeah. By the way, hello, Michael. Ada become Tagger Mask 5. Oh, my God. Let's see. Oh, BB Hulk is hurt. Oh, he's just a swollen calf muscle. Injury sidelines The Miz. Oh, grade 3 AC joint separation. That sounds brutal. Okay, not that bad. They make it sound worse than it was. Mr. Anderson is hurt. Inflamed tricep tendon. Well, that's not bad. Dalton Castle wants more money. It's like $1,400. Why not? Sure. And yeah, I think we're good. I think we're just good to go. No one else's messages are coming up. Oh, shit. Yeah, you might need to reload after that. Oh, damn. I feel like I need to go to some Stardom shows. It's kind of cool because I guess you can... Because I guess with all the matches pretty much already planned out for their Grand Prix, their 5-star Grand Prix, I guess they get something special if they pick all the matches correctly. Because it was like, okay, one fan correctly guessed all the results. He gets his photo in the ring with everyone. So, like, all the GP, the people doing the 5-star GP, they get a photo in the ring with them, which would be cool. And Oedo Tai gave him cup noodles that they cooked earlier when the main event began. So, like, I've seen that it's like, okay... You guess the results if you guess correctly, all of them. You get your picture in the ring with all the wrestlers. And Oedo Tai just made cup noodles and gave it to him. That's a fan in... That's fan interactions right there. That is... Kaho, Rio... Okay, they're here. Everyone is piled in. Check the injured VIP retirement. What? The injured VIP retirement. Those noodles will cost a whole 30 cents. Oh, injury sidelines. Sean Ricker. Lumbosacral sprain. Doesn't sound too bad. Yeah, 6 days. That's not bad. Change for Noelle Foley. Understood, about to debut a new style for her in-ring work. I didn't even know Noelle Foley was in... Oh, no. Yeah, I did. I have used her as a... Yeah, that's right. News archives. Oh, shit. Hang on. I'm brain farting here. There we go. Let's see. Injuries this year. Ba-ba-ba-ba. 29 right there. Oh, shit. Hang on. Oh, Vicious Impact Power. Announced today he's retiring from active competition. Oh. Oh, shit. Is that the shit that Shibata went out for? That's hematoma is like bleeding in the brain. I don't know if that's the same thing, but yeah, that's pretty much like he got Shibata'd, yeah. God damn. I recognize that. I'm like, Jesus. Woof. Yeah, subhematoma. Jesus Christ. That's rough. Engagement for Tessa Blanchard. Tessa Blanchard and Ricochet. Oh, good for them. And Liam Thompson and Carmel. Oh, whatever. Sure. Cool. So what? What is she? She's an entertainer. Did she already change or... Oh, she's best known for her regular wrestler style. Really? Is she best known for anything besides her Instagram? Let's just move on. Took a year and a half to renounce retirement. Oh, man. Ricochet still gets tests in the universe. Oh, right. I guess I put it on my Twitter for the people who saw that on my Twitter. But, yeah. I guess I should put this on stream for the people who don't follow me on Twitter, which if you don't, I don't blame you. But I did change the logos. So just to showcase, this was the original Adrenaline logo that I came up with, and I have a slightly more streamlined version of it, which looks now like that. So I kind of like just a slightly more flat, cleaner look for Adrenaline. So I really like that one. I'm still kind of back and forth on... Breakouts. Now, Breakout, this is the one I've been using for a while now. And so I wanted to do something that was... I still like it. Like, I still liked it, but I still wanted to kind of change it. So I made it... this is how Breakouts looks now. So, yeah, that is how... that is how it's looking now. I don't know where you get all this time from. I mean, it doesn't take much. I mean, to be fair, when you look at Adrenaline, it's literally a font colored and then some boxes that I skewed to look like that. So it wasn't really much. And then Breakouts was just a font with this on here and then added some stroke to it. Not too bad. It's just like little bitty tweaks and stuff. But hey, we're on YouTube. Where do they want... Oh, God damn it. Are we at that point now where they're just going to suggest Puerto Rico all the time? I always hate that. I always hated that about this. I don't want to go to Puerto Rico. There's nothing... Like, there's a lot of things that don't... Like, I'm good just not going there. I could do... I could do the Mid-Atlantic region. I'm trying to think here. What would be helpful? Puerto Rico would be the most helpful, but no. Let's just do that one. Run a TNA episode. Yeah, I don't know why Heyman and Violent J don't like each other. I don't know if I'm going to try to... Here. I guess I'll meddle with that. Let's see that. Paul Heyman... And Violent J Attorney at Law. No effect. All right, cool. Just telling him, like, hey, Paul, I think you would get along with Violent J. He's older. He's not, you know, he's not the guy that maybe you think he is. And I just turned to Violent J. He's like, Violent J, would you like to try to get along with Paul Heyman? And make him your homie. All right, let's just move on from that. 5,000. Let's go anywhere between 4 and 6. There we go. let's see, 5,000. DC, Maryland. Trying to see if there's a good I wonder if there's anything with a reputation. There is nothing with a reputation around here. Good. Let's go to North Carolina. That's gonna give me something. Greenville, Raleigh, Charleston, South Carolina. Is there really not a nice mid-level place in Charlotte to run? I'll run Winston-Salem. Fuck it. Let's run Winston-Salem. Lame, we went overseas. I'm going to do that, I think. Enjoy. Oh, God. Why did I... Oh, ICP's new Glade plug-in commercial? Oh, no. All right, I gotta. God damn it. No. I'm not watching the rest of that. Not because I shouldn't, but just no. I should probably have my workbook up so I actually know what the fuck I'm getting ready to book for. That'd be a good idea. LJVM Coliseum Annex holds 4,000 people. Maybe I should do 5,000. Just be like, you know what? Screw it. 5,000. Let's fill the place out. There you go. Caribous A&E Center. And like I usually like to do, I like to see just where in the hell this is and see generally it has some sort of, there we go. Generally it is some sort of, what is it? College building. Literally just looks like a building out in the middle of nowhere. Maybe that's just the wrong picture. But it looks alright. Okay, everything I find is not great. But I'm just going to assume this place exists and just not really worry too much about the fact that there just seems to be prisons everywhere on this. I mean, there is Caribous Arena, so an event center, so it looks okay. All right. Just insult the nearest sports team. Just talk about the love for like Villanova. I'm sure that'll get over in North Carolina. All right. Let's see here. I can run anywhere. You know what? All right, let me see. Maybe not overseas. Where's a good place to go in friggin' January? See, that's the thing. I have less than 1,000 people right now. I mean, I guess it wouldn't matter that much. Should I do an Australian tour? God. Book a prison show. I'll just go here, and then I'll figure something out next week. I don't know. It's summertime in Australia right now. That'd be... not too bad. A New Zealand show. Oh, God. Oh, I could draw 1,000 fans for most of these places. All right. People are. See, once again, I know you're going to be like, you bend to the will of everybody, you shithead. All right. About 1,000. Let's just keep it at, oh, God. Eastern, Central, New Zealand, Western. Oh, my God. Really? This is... All right, let's go 900 and let's go up to 2,000. All right, there's a place in Western Australia. There's a place in New Zealand. Okay. All right, now we got some places. I feel like maybe Western Australia. I don't know. Maybe there's something in Eastern Australia. That'd be better. Aussie open job out to someone. You know what? Fuck it. I'm staying where I am. I'm not dealing with this. I'm staying in North Carolina. We're not doing this. Fuck it. I know you guys aren't going to like it, but fuck it. I kind of realized as I'm doing this, I'm like, oh yeah, because we haven't really been in Australia much, nobody's over. Nobody's over there. It's going to be a shit show. Maybe later. There's a place in New Zealand with 950. I did see that. Yeah. No. All right. Matches. I'm thinking I don't want to do Shinsuke or Tama because they got fucked. I kind of know angles that I want to run, but I don't want to run that right now. It's just pure racism. What the fuck? against Australians or New Zealanders. Foreigners in Australia. Yeah, I truly hate foreigners. Don't clip that. Let's see here. In a match. Why the fuck? Sorry, that was really weird. I heard something outside my door. It sounded like a moan. But I didn't, my roommate didn't come with anybody. Like, he didn't come home with anybody. I don't know if he's just sleeping. I have no idea. I'm not going to worry about it. I'm just going to worry about me. I need to look at my stables and see my stable list. In fact, that's probably how I'll start booking. All right, we need a six-man. Six-man will be nice to establish one of our new stables that we brought in. There, that'll help out. Prince Devitt. And we established Chris Hero. And then we also established at Final Fight Adam Cole. Now, as to who they face, let's go with Day One. I don't think they've faced. Also, Adam Cole facing Day One. Adam Cole hating the Day One members. It's poetry at this point. Matt Cage. And let's go Cody Hall. Juice is too good for this shit. All right. So Rock and Roll Fight Team versus Day One in six-man tag action. And let's go about 12 minutes. Enough to be competitive, but not too much. Too long needs to cut the don't clip that. Let's go with Hero. How about that? The minimum is 5 seconds. Let's see here. Open match. Can't blackmail him to go to New Zealand or Australia with that. decisive win. Should I do? Yeah, decisive win. Sometimes the heels just win. They don't have to cheat, they just win. Let's see here. Oh, when is... I need to figure this out. I think it's still at least a couple weeks away when Taylor Mulligan shows up. 13 days. All right. So, yeah, we still got just under 2 weeks. Heels winning clean. Wow. That'll be fine. Let's see. Of course, it'll be America. I go to Japan every year. I already have a Japanese tour set up for it. In fact, I changed the name of the pay-per-view coming up in April when we go there. That was another thing I changed in my schedule. Tyler Debuts Racist. Wow. We should do... I'm trying to think, because I have an idea. I don't know if I want to do it right now. Actually, yes, we're going to do tag team match. Let's do Time Splitters and... This should be the main event, I think. Whoever Time Splitters face, as long as it's not like Roppongi 3K or the Birds of Prey, that should be it. And it shouldn't be the Young Bucks, because I don't want to do the rematch right now. Or the rematch period. We'll see to that. I could do Los Ingobernables, but I want to give them a little bit of momentum push. So maybe just have a drag out with the Wolves one last time for good old time's sake. They just go at it for 22, 23 minutes. That seems like an idea. Also, I'm realizing why I'm just sitting here and I just kind of realize that my head is at just this weird like 30 degree angle cocked to the left. Like my head's just a little too heavy for my body. And I understand why I have these like dark spots on my neck. I had my mom think it was like a hickey. She's like, "Is that a hickey?" I'm like, "No, unfortunately." I just lean my head to the side sometimes. Let's give it to Shelly. And open match. Call it in the ring? Maybe we should do... I think they can call it in the ring. I'm going to go ahead. Well, actually, okay. I don't think Davey can do it, I guess. Alright, so we'll do slow build, call it in the ring. Let's do a decisive win. And that'll be a main event match there. And I want to do... What the fuck? I know you're joking, but it's because Alex Shelley isn't as over as Kushida is. In fact, I think Alex Shelley is like a kind of a step, like a decent step below him. Like he's, look at that, he's in like the 70s and stuff, and then you have Kushida, who's like one of the top guys. It's crazy. C+, what the... I have no idea why. It's not like I haven't been pushing them. It's not like they haven't been pushed hard for the last year. I don't get it. Look, they were so over in May. And, like, these guys have won constantly, and then he just lost, like, a bunch in the Great Lakes area after losing the titles. I don't get it. You weren't expecting a valid reason, but that's pretty valid. I don't understand. It's like I hit the ceiling with him, and that's where he's at. Because I know everyone kind of has their arbitrary, like, ceilings, and maybe I found Alex Shelley's arbitrary ceiling. Okay. Oh, man. Okay. This needs to be a match. Alex Reynolds. Should it be? Now that I'm thinking about it, it was only a few days ago. Man, I'm really trying to get this figured out here. How many matches do I have right now? Okay, I have the six man. I have a tag team. Fuck it, I'll do the one-on-one. Why not? He'll be okay. I don't think he's hurt. The pop ceilings, yeah. Can we, like, dock Shelley's pay a little bit? He is getting paid a lot, isn't he? I think it's like 30-some thousand a month. Robert Roode. All right, he's hurt. But he's not out, as far as I remember, right? No, Joe is out. Alex Reynolds is hurt. All right, this could be the storytelling match then, which will probably be good for Alex Reynolds, for his, why are they always giving Chono these? It'll probably be good for Reynolds, injury. So 16 minutes, we won't slow build. Robert Roode getting the victory. This will be the storytelling match. They'll also be open and call it in the ring, and we're gonna go decisive, but it's gonna be a flash pinfall win. So he's gonna beat him clean, but he's gonna beat him with a roll up. So it's like Juice Robinson's wins. It's like he didn't cheat. It's just a move. But he didn't just, like, force his shoulders down, you know, with a move. Like, knock him out so badly, that's what happened. Tell that to Jay White. Tozawa Doi. We should do that one. Let's see. We should do... I'm trying to get away from doing one-on-one matches. I think I mentioned that last time, but I just wanted to make sure. Did I see the UK women's belt? Yeah, looks good. I mean, it looks like, you know, the women's version of the UK belt, which I'm not surprised by. So. All right, yeah, I think I can do that then. So let's do Naruki Doi and Roppongi 3K. So Sho and Yo. And since he's kind of feuding with Sammy will be out there with, let's go, Father Kingston and Johnny Hawkeye. What did he wrestle last? That's not helpful. Johnny Hawkeye and the American Wolves. Okay, perfect. Perfect, perfect. Bob Sapper's the entire roster. Jesus. All right. Doi, Sho, and Yo versus Sabe, Kingston, and Hawkeye. That'd be bomb. So, we pretty much already have... the name. I don't know if I made that the official stable yet, but Monster Max, the name of their stable. I think I mentioned that at final when I did that. Some of these names are not good. As in what? The Sammy Sabe, Father Kingston, and Johnny Hawkeye. What's not good about these? Let's go. Yeah, we can do that. About 13. Well, you know what? Let's give Sammy the win. One of the Roppongi guys can lose. That'll be fine. Open match, decisive win. Something about them puts you off. Probably just because it's not the same that you're used to hearing, I guess. It's not the same. To be fair... now that Johnny Hawkeye is away from that, I could maybe change him to, you know, Johnny Mundo or John Hennigan. I should do that. I should do that as like the like a revitalization of his character. It's 2020. We're changing stuff up, you know. What's this song called? Been looking for it everywhere. I know it's by Special Thanks. Hey You by Special Thanks. Special Thanks is all one word. I really like their songs. I don't know. I found them a couple years ago, and I just, like... it's probably been, like, 3 years when I first found them. But, yeah. So, we'll just do that. And then, you know what? Yeah. It's a new year. He's out of, is there any alter egos that would be... yeah, I don't like any of those, so let's just do John Hennigan. Because he goes by John Hennigan anyway. Doesn't he? Pretty sure. Here we go. We're gonna... This will be a new era for him. The Hawkeye stuff was when he was in Revolt. This is different. I could call him Boone the Bounty Hunter. I don't know if there's a good picture of him in like his bounty hunter gear. Actually, from the way it looks, it was pretty much just him in occasionally in shield outfit, but most of the time just shirtless, because it's fucking John Hennigan. Because, of course, he's going to be shirtless. Have you seen the man? Johnny, I just like Johnny takes the name of the company he's working for and uses it. Yeah. So let's auto name it again, and we're gonna rechange this to Monster Max. There you go. Monster Max was Seamus Bay, Father Kingston, and John Hennigan. He gets to be reborn. Even though he wasn't last week, he gets to be reborn as a new guy. That's fine. I mean, what? He changed his whole goddamn gimmick and character in a matter of like 2 days when he was in ECW. So I think it'll be fine. And I think that's good enough for the four matches. So now we book around what we are doing. So, of course, we need to do the intro because we didn't do like an official introduction for the Rock and Roll Fight Team. We did with Hero, but not so much Adam Cole. And Bob Sapp, of course, with that. So he's Menace. Hero? Can Hero talk? Hero can talk just fine. All right. Thanks for coming by, Michael. I appreciate it. Here we go. Minor successes everywhere for that. Wow. All right. So, let's see. Rock and Roll Fight Team out. Let's see. Intros, new member Adam Cole. And Devitt insults Shibata. Shibata's MMA skills. Because I'm pretty sure he only won but a couple fights, if I remember right. Let me see. Katsu, Yori, Shibata, MMA. Let me see Sherdog. Katsu, Yori, the Mad Dog. 4 wins, 11 losses. I knew he had, like, way more losses than wins. But, yeah, 4 wins, 11 losses. Oofta. So, yeah. It's not hard to insult his dealio. His MMA skills. 5 minutes? Four minutes. How about that? Let's do 4 minutes. I guess 5 minutes if it's, you know, a few people talking now. So, save that. And let's see here. So, we've got that. The after... Who did I have winning this again? Hero. We might just leave it alone right now, actually. Alex Reynolds, entertainment, he'll come out, minor success. And let me see here. Reynolds out with a mic. Upset that he failed. And will work towards becoming champ again. And making, you know what? We'll just do that. He's like, you know what? I'll fight, scratch, and claw once again to become champ. It's almost babyface-ish doing that. I want to make sure everyone is available. See, he's hurt, though, I thought. I thought he's out. Let me see. Joe are unable to perform due to injury. That means they can still do angles. Okay. I guess when some of them... Okay, well, I guess he's already pushed that way, so I'm not gonna mess with it. So Reynolds and Robert Roode. Reynolds gonna take the loss. Brother Ray coming out. And Samoa Joe. Alex upset he lost again. Ray out to What's a good way to put this? Ray out and is done with him. Whoops. Joe, Coquina clutch to Alex is aligned with Ray. There you go. Basically his brother Ray telling him like, okay, well, I'm done with you. I decided that this whole deal of, you know, trying to make you my golden boy is done. And that's when Joe shows up. So definitely a minor defeat, low injury risk. I'd say, you know, decent success on both of them. There you go. Right after that one. Time Splitters, American Wolves. So, Alex Shelley and Kushida. I'm trying to figure this out here. You know what? I've got an idea then. All right. Time Splitters out. They mourn the loss of their titles by playing a tribute to their reign on the screen. There you go. Good 4 minutes, I guess. Should it be overness? Eh, why not? Yeah. Minor successes. And then Alex Shelley and Kushida post-match. Entertainment on both. Time Splitters post-match. Had a talk after final fight and have decided to mutually part ways. Basically, they have taken their tag team success as far as they feel that they can go, and they're going to go sorting out themselves as singles competitors. There we go. That'll be interesting. We'll see. I'll probably have to. I still have the good point of the stables is that I'll be able to start like putting more tag teams potentially together who aren't teamed up right now. So that might be helpful. Let's see. Monster Max, Sami Zayn, Father Kingston, John Hennigan. Okay. Let's see here. Yeah, we should do like the intro for it. A mutual split with no heel turn. Shenanigans. It's a rare thing to have happen. Kingston with Sammy and Hennigan. Hennigan has dropped the Hawkeye and... Oh, here we go. I got it. Let's do... There we go. Do I want to sign those guys? I mean, I already have Balor. The other guys I can't really sign due to contracts. Let me see. Okay, let me try this again. All right. Kingston out with Sammy and... Here, Kingston out with Sammy. Let's see. Says Hawkeye has seen the light and is born again as John Hennigan. No longer going by the name that he has gone by from his Revolt days. He is born again as John Hennigan. There you go. I feel like we would still need a little something with Monster Max out there. I do not have a figurehead. No one is really that capable enough. There's always a little bit of something that wouldn't make them a good figurehead, so I just don't have one. Which just seems to be for the better anyway. Let's see. Tozawa. Naruki Doi. Sho. And Yo. So, entertainment. Those two will just stand there and look pretty. Monster Max out. Talks about... let's see. Infamous. And... how Doi will still come out with TV title. Close enough on that one. Let's see. Minor successes there. And we have the 8-man match. Or 6-man. That's right. Tozawa's out there with Doi, but that's whatever. You know. So put that out there. Friend to play TEW. I mean, I don't mind you hanging out. I don't really play TEW with other people. That's the thing. I think the only person I'd probably do that with is my roommate, just because I can kind of sync that up with him. It's nothing personal. I just don't really do that. Okay, so the post. I'm trying to see if there's anything in the post. I think that might be it. I need to think like how I'm gonna end the show. I don't know if I want to end it with that or if I want to end it with something else. I'm trying to think. All right, I'm trying to look and see perhaps what I have for the upcoming pay-per-view. You know what? Maybe I can do. I gotta do something with Omega after what happened there. I don't know if I want to end the show with it or do it in the middle of the show. Maybe I should end it. Maybe I should end it that way. So maybe we can do Kenny Omega, Matt Jackson, and Nick Jackson. I do not have a Discord. I don't have like a personal Discord. Hiromu. Yeah. Selling. The Elite. Find Hiromu backstage by himself and jump him to leave him laying. There we go. So a bit of an after deal with what happened thanks to the final fight deal. And that will deal with that. Oh man, I'm trying to see what else there is. I should probably do something. Hiromu should win matches with interference from Daryl. I don't know why I haven't done that, but that doesn't sound too bad at all. All right, 109 minutes. Let's do... God... I should have Shane Hollister come out. So Shane Hollister comes out, does his deal. I'm trying to think if anyone should come out for that. Yeah, we'll see what we've got here. Yes, let's see. Shane out to celebrate winning. Celebrate defending his title. And is glad to have overcome his past failures at the highest possible level. good 6 minutes to really like get that over. I mean, he really did like get over the major hump that he needed to get over. And how apropos it would be if like you cut to commercial and then Reynolds comes out like 3 minutes later. All right, pin Daryl, keep Hiromu strong. Daryl gets the pin. I love the idea if I just get here, like get Daryl to just take all the pins. It's like, of course, he just tags in his plush doll and then they just pin him immediately. All right. First Dojo grad is just Daryl. Maybe I should look at the history. Let me see what I can come up with final fight. Yeah. I don't think all of these guys really play TEW that much. You know, that's just their thing. I think they mostly just come to hang out. Juice. Oh, we should have Juice out. Juice should face... Oh, okay. I've got it. Okay. I definitely wanted to do this. So... Yeah, I know the Grey Dog forums are usually pretty good for getting co-op TEW. You can usually get someone there. I found out that like apparently this skin like kind of got over in that. Like, cause I can't remember who Mortimer Mouse told me. He was like, oh, by the way, people really love that skin on the TEW forums, but you know, people generally can't get a hold of it. And I'm like, oh shit, okay. But it seems like, yeah, people thought it was pretty dope. Let's go. Oh, I remember in Juice is in an angle, yeah. I wanna set this up. I don't know how exactly I want to set this up. I have an idea. Actually, yeah, let's do selling. All right. Let's see. Juice out for a match. To prove himself. Done blindsides with opportunity trophy and hit with bitter end. Juice wants to go balls deep in Dunn's trophy. Oh my god. Minor defeat, low injury risk, minor success. There you go. Boom, boom, boom. All right, let's put that about here-ish. Yeah, that's probably a good place. Twitch Presents is doing Pokemon on Monday. Didn't they already do... Oh, no. That's the show, not the Twitch Plays Pokemon. Yeah, I saw that. Every single thing of Pokemon, which is perfectly timed with, like, forcing everyone who has Twitch Prime to watch commercials. Fuck. I wonder if it's going to be... It's probably going to be the English dub, which is really going to be something, because the only English dub that I know of is the 4Kids dub. So I don't know if it's going to be, like, you know, Brock saying, man, these donuts are amazing, and it's like, it's a rice... Like, it's a rice cake. I think that's what they were. But yeah, it's like one of those things where it's like, oh, man, these donuts are delicious. I'm like, that's not a donut. The whole series has been dubbed. Okay. Well, that's the thing, is I don't know if they've gone back away from the... So it'll definitely be donuts instead of rice cakes. Take my frying pan and turn it into a drying pan. There was a phenomenal... I'm getting off track here just a little bit, but if you ever look up on YouTube... Evangelion 4Kids dub. Or even just Evangelion 4Kids. You can find Neon Genesis Evangelion The Lost 4Kids opening. And it's great. Okay. One second here. Okay, so I have a couple. I have at least one more segment I can do, if not two. I'm trying to think if I want to do anything after the Shane thing. Probably not. I do kind of want to do an update on Tama and Nakamura, so maybe we'll do that. So, Brother Ray, Tama Tonga, Shinsuke Nakamura. They are off screen, and there you go. Ray, in his office, announces that Nakamura is fine. Well, okay, I'm trying to think here. Maybe instead of Brother Ray, I just have Tama Tonga come out and insult him. No, because I kind of want to move away from that at this point. Yeah, fuck it. Tama Tonga, Shinsuke Nakamura, and off screen, we'll not do overness. Tama's bandage up, but proud of beating Nakamura. Found out he's fine, but might not make Infamous. Whoops. Infamous. There you go. He's fine, but not, maybe not in time. One Piece is OP. But yeah, the Four Kids dub of Evangelion is just... Hey, Shinji, get in the robot. Your dad loves you. Get in the robot. Don't eat a rice cake. Eat a donut. I guess it wouldn't be minor success. Maybe success because, hey, there you go. Without Asuka from Germany, everybody would be lost. Her country is responsible for the holographic map. We'll open up with that. How about that? There you go. We freestyling now? No, it's part of the Evangelion 4 Kids opening. All right. I think we are solid then. 125 minutes. Yeah. I hope I don't get... I'm not going to show the video because it's just the Evangelion opening with that, but maybe I shouldn't. There we go. Let me see if I can just do that and then... Oh, God, yeah, that's probably... I just realized, like, the beginning's probably gonna... Maybe. I just want to talk over it here. I'm just checking to make sure I have everything. Thanks, I hate this. Without Asuka from Germany, everybody would be lost. Her country is responsible for the holographic map. Shinji said that daddy cannot take it for a whirl and use it to help my friend save the world. Your dad loves you, yeah. The biggest lie. Your dad loves you. Get in the robot. What in your Evangelion? Yo, Shinji, get in the robot. Your dad loves you. Get in the robot. The cockpit's too small. It's... Okay, I guess I didn't mention, but it's not actually a Four Kids opening. They wouldn't dare play Evangelion in a Four Kids dub. Like, it's a parody, so that's what makes it funny. I think it's a funny enough parody. I think it's a funny enough parody. A bridged opening for a series? I don't know. Maybe no one wants to try to take on Evangelion as an abridged. Yeah, sorry, it's not official. That's not the legit opening, no. They wouldn't. There's no way four kids would ever do Evangelion on Evangelion on Saturday. Oh my God, Saturday morning Evangelion would be frightening. Oh, there's no way they would show that to kids. It's not kid friendly enough. Although it'd be funny. It's like right around the time Asuka just starts like fucking mental breakdown. Yeah, no, there's too much like mental breakdowns and boobs to do that. Yeah, the censoring in it would be insanity. All right, let's run the show because this is enough time. Jesus. Yeah, dude, Yu-Gi-Oh! Legit, like, he set people up. He did one, I think there was one point where he, like, covered a guy's hand in something. I forget what it was. I don't think it was gasoline, but he covered a guy's hand in something and then lit, like, a Zippo lighter and put it on, like, the back of his hand and basically told him, like, all right, well, now you gotta balance this. And then he just fucking walked away as the guy. He just had to balance this goddamn Zippo on his hand, covered in gasoline. But yeah, Tama Tonga coming out to start off the show. 5,000 people selling out in Cabarrus Arena and Event Center in North Carolina. And Tom was bandaged up after surviving the Last Man Standing match. Of course, he beat Shinsuke Nakamura for that. And he's proud of beating Nakamura. He's, you know, he said he was going to do it. He told people that he didn't think Nakamura could. And yeah, ends up beating him and showcased his skill level. And found out that Shinsuke Nakamura is fine. He doesn't have any extensive injuries that are key to keep him sidelined. But he's a question mark for Infamous, which is more than fine for Tama Tonga, because he also lets people know that he himself should be okay and good to go for Infamous. Even though he has a TV title match and a battle royal, he plans on winning both. And, you know, Shinsuke Nakamura might not be able to make that. And he just basically goes off into the sunset. Prince Devitt and the rest of the Rock and Roll Fight Team, as they seem to have been called at Final Fight, coming out with Chris Hero and Bob Sapp and their new member as a Final Fight, Adam Cole. As they introduce Adam Cole as the new member, and Devitt insults Shibata's MMA skills. Of course, they will be fighting each other in about 10 days at Infamous 47. So Prince Devitt getting his shots in on Katsuyori Shibata as Prince Devitt. Says that he has shown impressive skill. He's been undefeated thus far in MMA hybrid rules matches, and doesn't plan on changing that anytime soon, as opposed to Katsuyori Shibata's 4-11 MMA record. So we'll see what happens there. But first, we have the Rock and Roll Fight Team facing off against three members of Day One: Afanoi Jr., Matt Cage, and Cody Hall. God damn, these guys figured it the hell out. For a 12-minute match, that's quite good. I like that. But nonetheless, Chris Hero defeating Cody Hall with the Hangman's Clutch as the Rock and Roll Fight Team get their first real win as a team. I guess, I don't remember if they had a tag team match or something, but I might as well just activate them officially as a thing here. And so yeah, Rock and Roll Fight Team getting over Day One with this. And we move to Shane Hollister, who gives the babyface promo of the year, and it's only week one. It's only the first week in January, and Shane Hollister comes out with the ultimate babyface promo and the official title celebration. Just a few minutes. He didn't want anything big. Just wanted to thank the crowd for supporting him and continuing to cheer for him, despite the people in the chat that seem to not always do that. I forget exactly who it was. I'd have to look back again. But once again, defended his title. He's glad to have overcome his past failures and gotten over the hump that he has had in his career of being considered a bit of a fluke. So he is glad to have gotten over that, despite the uphill battle that he always seemed to have. And Alex Reynolds, after maybe a commercial, comes out. He's got a microphone. He's ready for his match. And he's not happy that he failed. He understands that he failed. But with this look of sort of anger, frustration, and just general unhappiness, says that he is going to work towards being champ again. He wants to make Brother Ray proud. You know, Brother Ray has put his faith, his heart and soul behind him, and he failed him at Final Fight. But that will all change as he will fight to become champ one more time. And he has his match against Robert Roode. And after fantastic heat and great wrestling, Alex Reynolds gets rolled up by Robert Roode. And will take the loss. He was slowed by injury. You know what? They did perfectly fine. So Reynolds getting rolled up by Robert Roode. Robert Roode getting a surprising win over the former three-time heavyweight champ. God, I'm trying to think about it. 3 years ago, then he didn't win it until last April, and then again in June. So yeah, three times. Ah, there we go. Had something in my eye. And it is after that Alex Reynolds just looks like he's about ready to cry. He just doesn't look... He doesn't look the worst. He doesn't look the best right now. And Brother Ray comes out. Ray grabs a mic, and Alex Reynolds seems to be, you know, telling him, like, hey, listen, I just need some time. I just need to work at it a little bit. Brother Ray seems to be somewhat consoling. But then lets him know that he's done with him. He's outlived his usefulness, and he's not going to fire him. There's no need to fire him. He's still a solid wrestler, but basically has told him that as far as him and Brother Ray are concerned, they are no longer a thing. And he will not receive the support that he wants. And that brings Samoa Joe out to kind of blindside him. Kind of comes up from behind, rises up behind Alex Reynolds. And even though he's hurt, locks in the coquina clutch. And proceeds to choke Alex Reynolds out. As Brother Ray seems to have tossed Alex Reynolds aside as he stands with Samoa Joe. And Samoa Joe seems to have perhaps a new association with Brother Ray. And we get Juice Robinson. He's coming out for a match, just kind of an impromptu match. Don't really know against who it's going to be. He wants to continue to prove himself. And Joe and Ray, as if Joe needed a mic piece. I know. I mean... There are guys that generally don't, like, CM Punk didn't need a mic piece, but he was still put with Paul Heyman, and it was still great. You know, they just bounce off one another. Juice Robinson coming out for a match. His music is hit. He seems to be waiting on somebody. And Pete Dunne's music hits. Seems a little bit surprised as he didn't think he was going to face Dunne. But nonetheless, Dunne coming out from the crowd, blindsides him, hits him with the opportunity trophy case, and flattens him with a bitter end. Grabs the mic real quick and basically just insults him for thinking that he's going to prove himself worthy, holds up the briefcase and says that this is what truly proves him worthy. And that is it. Pete Dunne just laying out and insulting Juice Robinson for having hopes and dreams, and leaves. Alex Shelley and Kushida come out. Of course, they are no longer the tag team champs. It feels kind of weird because for the exception of about 2 months, these guys were champs for about 10 of the last 12 months. Of course, Kushida had that whole broken neck and everything, but recovered from it, and they seem to have been at the top of the game, beating just about everybody except for the Young Bucks, of course. And they kind of mourn the loss of the titles, and they play a bit of a tribute to the last year of their title reign and their existence here in Hawkeye Pro on the big screen to showcase how their title reign went. And then we get to the Time Splitters versus the American Wolf Sensational Wrestling Fantastic Heat. The Time Splitters get the win. Alex Shelley hits Shiranui and ends up pinning Davey Richards. That's probably for the better. Little Drummer Flow at nobody in the ring had the psychology to take the control properly. Fucking American Wolves. And probably Shelley. Kushida, I would imagine, has the chemistry. I don't know. But nonetheless, still pulled off a great match. And Time Splitters get the win. But they seem a little distracted and still a little sad. Yeah, I blame Davey and slightly less, a little bit more less Eddie. But mostly Davey. Davey wouldn't know, Davey wouldn't know ring psychology if he was fucking slapped in the dick with it. That seems extra harsh. I think he's had some decent matches, but it's been a lot of, I just remember watching those days of Ring of Honor when they were on Go Fight Live, and they weren't, psychology-heavy matches. You're not watching Davey Richards matches for the story. But either way, the Time Splitters seem to have a little something more to say after this, and they decide to end the show with a post-match talk, just to say that they had a serious discussion about their future after Final Fight and what they would do, and decided that that there's really nothing left for them to do. In the tag team division, they basically both agree that, for as good as they have been thus far, there's just nothing left for the Time Splitters to accomplish in the tag team division. So while they're more than happy to remain friends, they have decided to mutually part ways as a tag team and pursue individual singles careers, which should definitely... They also mentioned Infamous and the 10-man Battle Royals. They're both a part of it. And say that perhaps one of those singles careers can absolutely kick off at Infamous, depending on how that all goes. So they shake hands and walk out, and that is the end of the Time Splitters. Uh-oh, real fast. Sammy Sabay and Father Kingston coming out. Father Kingston seems personally very, very what's the word? Very energetic. You're doing some music shit. Give me a wrestling thing to sample. I have no idea what you mean by that. I have no idea what type of thing you want. I don't know music. I have no idea exactly what you mean. I apologize. I'm very lost. But either way, I'll get to it in a second. Father Kingston, wrestling related, to use and sample to make a song. I can't think right now. I'm sorry. I got TEW brain. Kingston coming out, he's particularly energetic with Sammy, and Kingston has he has brought his book out. They have a portable sermon table that he puts his Bible on, and he has proclaimed that he has helped save another member of Hawkeye Pro Wrestling, much like his Arabic brethren in Sami Sabay. Another man has seen the light. He has seen the truth, and he is born again. And so Johnny Hawkeye has been born again as John Hennigan. And that is when John Hennigan comes out, and not much has changed other than the name, because that's just kind of how he's rolled his entire career. So there you go. But he's now, instead of Johnny Hawkeye, he's John Hennigan. And Tozawa, Doi, and Sho and Yo come out. Monster Max. Talk about Infamous. Of course, Naruki Doi has his TV title match. Doi, he says, no matter what type of bells and whistles you want to put on, how many people you've been able to save or whatnot and see the light and everything else. The fact of the matter is that it's just going to be Sami Sabay in the ring with Doi and Tama Tonga. And Naruki Doi, the rightful winner of the match, of the title match for Infamous, will still come out with a TV title, even with Sami Sabay there. And that leads us to our main event, six-man tag, Naruki Doi, Roppongi 3K, versus Sammy, Father Kingston, and John Hennigan. Naruki Doi carried everybody else. Look at that 96 by himself. Jesus Christ. The Monster Max, their graveyard smash. Oh, my God. Jesus. Either way, great, great little match here. Not the biggest match, but still a great little match. Let's see here. Sami Sabay defeating Sho. Cool. Yeah, it's a play on the Akira Tozawa, who used to be the head of Monster Express, and Naruki Doi, who I believe is still the leader of Maximum. Yeah, pretty sure. Unless something has happened in the last couple weeks. I mean, I know about certain things about other people leaving Maximum, but I'm pretty sure Doi is still in, maybe not like in charge of it, but still one of the big members in Maximum. So yeah, Monster Max is kind of a play on Maximum Express and, or Monster Express and Maximum. Either way, Sami Sabay gets the win for his team, and Sabay, Kingston, and John Hennigan get the win over them, and that is how we end it. To the back, to end the show, Hiromu Takahashi seems to be by himself right now, perhaps in a odd corner or hallway with Daryl. Seems to be just kind of sitting there. Doesn't seem to have the other Los members around him. And that is when Kenny Omega and the Bucks, as you see kind of in the background, seem to have come across him, stumbled across him as they run him down and jump him while he's busy with Daryl. And they beat the snot out of Takahashi. They just kind of toss him around onto various equipment and beat him up and everything else and leave him laying at the end of that. And there you go. That is, yo was used too much. Whatever. Who cares? That's the end of Adrenaline. Why did that take an hour and a half? How did that happen? Oh, God damn it. No. Oh, God. You've been awoken to what trap remixes of songs. All right, let's see what's happened here. 6.01. Jesus Christ almighty. 4.5 million people. What did the last one get? 4.1. So now that we've gotten a lot better TV coverage, we got a jump of 400,000 people now. 4.5 million views on YouTube. I think we trending, boys. We trending. Oh, we're going. We're going. Wednesday nights. Wednesday nights is Adrenaline. Trending worldwide on YouTube. Anything happen? Shelton Benjamin sidelined. Broken wrist. Oh, shit. That'll take him for... Yeah. Should be not too long, though. Yeah, 23 days. That's about what I was about to say. I was going to say about a month. Oh, no. Punchy. A Jones fracture. Oh, God. That sounds awful. 49. Wow. Oh, my God. He already had one. He just came back from a Jones fracture. Oh, his poor fucking legs. Then he got a fractured his wrist, a TFCC chair, partially rubs. Jesus Christ. The fuck, Punch? He's resilient as shit. Good lord. Don Fuji heading for injury? That's the funniest part, is I'm pretty sure Don Fuji, he's not had any injuries. The man's almost 50. Then again, well, actually, no, he doesn't have... Punch's in-ring is not nearly as bad as a lot of other guys in Dragon Gate. HPW gone viral, prank gone sexual, gone Japanese. And it's just like Tama Tonga with like a scared look on his face. Get punched, Tominaga. Wow. Just like one of our top guys with like it's just Tama Tonga with a scared look on his face, holding up a cell phone with like Shinsuke Nakamura on the cell phone. And the thumbnail just says, "Don't do this at 3 a.m. Don't call Shinsuke Nakamura at 3 a.m. This is what happens." Mid-Atlantic. Let me see what this is. Winthrop. So NC Winthrop Coliseum, 6,100. Sure, why not? All right, match time. Obviously no EO, no Kana. You go viral for a juice promo, then randomly have wrestlers vlog and do challenge videos. Yeah, that'd be the way to go. All right, we should have Mercedes out there. Kick someone's ass. I don't know who. Let's put someone out there. Who can we put up to get slaughtered? I mean, I could do Kangaroo Jess. I don't know if I want to do that. Maybe I'll do... you know what? Kangaroo Jess. Fuck it. Actually, no. I'm going to be using her big time what's the word? In an angle. Dastardly. Let's do Mary Dobson. We don't really put her in matches. What's her popularity look like? Okay. She's getting up there. Literally use YouTube to get over. Every week, sign a local, change their name to a parody of a YouTuber. Everyone, ladies and gentlemen. Already in the ring, weighing in at 205 pounds, Jack Paul. let's see. Sign PCO and just make him PDP. It's like, why PDP? Just you'll understand. let's see here. 12. She can go in the ring. I just never use her for that. This should be the storytelling match, though. I think it could work. We'll see if it works. Mercedes. Jack and Brogan, the Paul brothers. Sign Swagger. Jack, oh my god. Okay. It's Kenna. Jenna Jax. Oh. Jenna Jenga. Fuck. Oh, no. Oh, this is going to be just... This is my best idea since Insecticide. Oh, Jenna Jax. Oh, Jesus. I don't know. That was the one that got me. I don't know why, but that was the one that got me. God damn it. I just... All right. I think that's all I need. There you go. I just... let me see. What other matches can I do here? Let's do team one. Let's do... Reyna's. I think they lost last week. Pretty sure. Yeah, they had lost that six person. So let's do Idol Fight. Doesn't really help put them over that much, but not really something I care about too much right now. Plus they'll still probably get a bit of a boost from being in there with them. Bob Burnham. God damn it. He's not hardly even a YouTube star anymore. Just change one of my Japanese stars into, like, Rice Mint. How long should they go? Probably not long. Probably not too long. I mean, I know he started off, like, trust me, I like Bo Burnham, but I don't think he's so much a YouTube star anymore. Grain Spearmint. Oh, God. Yeah, let's give Hamada the win here. I'm thinking keep it simple for the other two. Nah, fuck it. They'll be fine. Open match, sure. That I think helps out these two, even in the loss. I'm trying to remember. I think it's Protect that helps them from losing too much, but yeah. I'm just, I don't know what to think about this. I don't like it. I don't like this. Let me see here. All right, main event. I should think of a main event. Let's go. Ooh, you know what? I've already got the one-on-one matches ready. Okay. So I know this. I need to set up for a number one contendership match. So after, no matter who wins at Infamous, I want to set up a sudden death four-way and get some matches together for that. So that's what I'm gonna do there. So we can maybe set up for that. So let's do like a one-on-one. And I'll just do, let's see, we can have Dash in her one-on-one role. Oh, who should she face? Ooh, maybe Courtney Rush would be a good match. Dash and Courtney Rush. Have they faced each other? Once. A long time ago. And it was a great match. Kigetsu, I wouldn't mind. But I don't know if I want to use them right now in matches. I kind of want to build them up in angles a little bit. Especially like lower tier angles. So, let's see. Spot in four-way contenders match. There we go. See how she holds with your best star? I could do that. Trying to think if there's someone better for that. Plus, having her face Dash is not really what I want to do for the story. I don't know what I want to do with the story, to be honest. I have an idea, but it doesn't really. If Dash is going over either way, I'm mostly doing it because I know it'll be a solid main event. Because Courtney Rush is popular enough, I think, to make it happen. Kigetsu in this case, I don't know if she would hold as much for that. I'm trying to make a solid main event here. You know, I like Kigetsu, but I kind of want to make like a solid main event for Dash and Courtney Rush to have. Yeah, Kigetsu wouldn't be like lower on the card like that. Or Kigetsu wouldn't be in that spot immediately. She'd be a little bit lower. But I do have ideas. Decisive, we can slow build it, and I think we're good there. It's the YouTube premiere breakout. Yeah. I do have an idea, though. I do have an idea. And so I know a certain someone who's going to hate this. Not someone in the chat, but a certain someone on the roster who's going to hate this. Yeah, I guess we could do a one-on-one. How about instead I put her... let me see here. Oh, she's not even available right now. What? Did I not put her in a position right now? Is that the thing? Hang on. Let's just auto push and let's see if that happened. She should be here, right? She should be available. That might have been a thing as I forgot to assign them a position. One-on-one. Let me look. Oh, there she is. Kiketsu. I like how you just knew Mayu was going to be jobbing out. God, that psychology is awful. Oof. All right, so call it in the ring. Not call it in the ring. One of them can't go longer than 18 minutes. The other can't call a match for shit. This is just something, huh? That's fine. They're both young. All right. I know she's going to get so pissed off by this. She's going to be so pissed. Well, only two women on that have attitudes. One isn't going to be booked tonight. Open match. Should we script this? Let's see. Psychology is less important if the match is called in the ring, as drawback prevents natural flow. You know what? Fuck it. Script that shit. I don't trust you. Don't keep her strong or protect if she's still mad. Yeah. If she doesn't want to do it, then fuck her. You know, this is probably why she's like a 60-something in the Midwest. Oh, God. She's such a fucking... Oh, she ain't gonna like this shit. Oh, she is so pissed. She's so pissed. Keep her strong. She gets the same amount of mad no matter what, and it only hurts the match rating. That's a very good idea. You know what? A minute. What's gonna happen anyway on top of that? I don't even care if she fucking takes the pin. There you go. I'll throw some money at her. She'll get paid a little bit extra money to take this. I just realized, now that I think about it, I've had that happen with her quite often, right? Mayu's kind of the person, my go-to, where it's like, she's really solid, but she also, like, she has to take some losses that she's not... She's the one that kind of takes the losses. There's one, there's two... There's three. I don't know why she was irritated at losing to Kyrie. I don't get that. There's four. There's five. Six. That's just in the last 9 months. That's just in the last 9 months. She's still influenced by her rapper gimmick. Ah, she's a legendary lackey. That's probably also... Oh, yeah. Yeah, she is so... She's pissed at that, and I don't care. 71 minutes I think is enough time. Yeah, that'll be fine. Kyrie was out for a year. She wasn't nearly as over as the other two. But that's the thing. If I look at Kyrie now, I want to look at Kyrie now. I want to see the difference. Look at that. Even going in, she was still in the 80s. Look at that shit. Fuck her. She just doesn't want a job to anybody. Fucking Hollywood Mayu Hogan over here. Thank God she doesn't have creative control. Oh, anniversary 3? Yeah. Yeah, if EO won, but that's not part of the story. We had to have... She didn't even take the fall either. EO took the fall. Yeah, I understand why she was probably irritated about that, because Mio also is not... I get it. I do get it, but it's like, I feel like you're just being a douche. Look at that shit. I can see why. Oh my God, I want to see Kagetsu real quick. Real quick, I want to see where she's at. Yeah. Ooh. There you go. And Kyrie wasn't as over then either. So I get that. That's all right. This is the new realm of pushing people. This is not in Australia. No, this is We're in North Carolina. A different building in North Carolina. So we'll be fine. It's just the Mid-Atlantic. Okay, so we got Mercedes Martinez and Mary Dobson. Let's see here. Yeah, we need Mercedes and Mary. And there we go. Let's do... Mercedes hits the cop killer on Dobson one more time to send a message to EO for Infamous. I guess it's low. Why did I put minor success? It's minor defeat. And put that there. Reyna's. All right. I think we need to do a little bit of each here. Let me see. I don't know if I want a pre-match thing, but I definitely want a post-match. So, let's see. Ayaka Hamada and Arisa Nakajima. Brittany Knight. You know what I just realized I didn't do that I wanted to do for this stream? Play the new intros I made. That was another thing. Besides the logos, I made new intros. I completely forgot about that. I might do that at the end. Just tack it on to the end. All right. Let's see here. Selling their match. They're going to talk. Reyna's celebrate as Revolution out. Whoops. Says they are rightful contenders after beating them last week. There you go. Just about 4 minutes to showcase that. I guess it's more neutral on them. Doesn't really matter that much. There you go. And set that up there. Paul Heyman out with Mayu and Miyu. Heyman out with Mayu and Miyu. Says EO is still recovering. Will be, whoops. Ready for Infamous. You guys just stay there and look pretty. I was about to hit this, and I would feel bad knowing that it, like, the sex appeal is not that high. Wow. Okay, so they're just gonna stand there and look okay. That sounds so bad. We'll just do EO off screen. We'll do that. That way we're still kind of talking about her and still kind of putting her over. There we go. Let's do like 5 minutes on that, because he'll talk a little bit about Mayu being there as well. Ooh, I just realized there are certain people I might not have assigned to much of anything right now. I don't know if I want to add them to much of anything. I'm still in an odd place with some of these people, but we'll move, let's see. Kagetsu and Hazuki And let me see here. We'll have them attack Mayu. How about that? And Miyu. I think this debuts them majorly. We'll go neutral because they were kind of blindsided by it. Here we go. Oedo Tai's music hits out of nowhere. Kagetsu and Hazuki blindside Mayu and Miyu for beatdown before Kagetsu faces. We'll just do that. And then, oh, by the way, you are fighting Kagetsu right now. You guys are never allowed to not feud with each other. I feel like there should be another person with them. I just don't know who. I don't know if I have someone in particular that would fit an Oedo Tai stable. I want to see that now. I just want to take a quick look. Any of the in-ring push women. So these are all the active female competitors, many of whom are already in some sort of stable. So the people who aren't are Candace. Jesus. Dash would actually work for Oedo Tai if I wanted to bring her there. They could just be a tag team. I don't have to really work anybody else. Jesus. Maybe if I brought in Maki and Reika to be a part of that, but I kind of already have a plan for them. Just kind of Kaho, but I'm probably going to do something else with her. Yeah, you know what? I'll just leave it as a tag team for right now. Describe how Oedo Tai works. Oh, boy. Sadistic group. Sadistic Joshi group that it just spends most of their time either dancing or hanging Mayu Iwatani from the rafters. That's what they do. When they're not spending their time dancing, they are generally making Mayu Iwatani's life a living hell. that's there you go. I guess really just maybe YouTube them. Kairi, Dash, Candace, and Azumi. I think those are... No, Azumi's kind of already with Kana and Miyu, even though they kind of already have, like... I don't know. I kind of have her with Miyu and James Mitchell and Kana as something. I did just kind of get an idea in my head, but I'm not going to say it right now. Because I do have an idea. So I'm going to leave it be. And we'll just let that go for now. But yeah, Oedo Tai will be a tag team. In fact, I should probably put that in here if it isn't. There we go. Oedo Tai. Kagetsu. Hazuki. A unit. Save it. While I'm here, time splitters are inactive. Oh, you know what? That might be why. I'm going to make them an inactive unit. And then hopefully that will remind me to make them a full unit at the time. I'm trying to think if there's anybody else that I might not. Oh, you know what? I'm going to make this inactive. Well, actually, I'm going to make it active. I'm going to keep it active because they could trade that off. All right. We're good. I hope that's saved. Oh, yeah, they're gone. There we go. Okay, Dash versus Courtney Rush. We should probably have the introduction to it. So, Mick Foley. There we go. Foley wants a number one contender. Let's see. For the future. So, setting up qualifiers now for four-way match. Boom. All right. What does Oedo Tai even stand for? I have no idea. I don't really know why. Hey, Okada, what's up? So we'll just throw that there since we're getting that ready. And that's right before Dash and Courtney Rush. We can use Leva Bates and Courtney Rush and Athena. So, entertainment. Leva Corp in their locker room. Whoops. Prepare for their match, and Neva says hers is next week. There you go. Matt, translate to? I don't even know what it translates to exactly, or if it translates to anything. I don't know if there's a... if I can have a meaning for it. Oh, Stardom Joshi. Oh, there's a couple times. What does Oedo Tai mean? Oedo translates to Great Edo, Edo being the old name of Tokyo, the classic period, which really, based on the way they dress and dance and act, that makes some sense. That makes some sense, because they do have a very, like, classical type look that they use. Classic period when Japan, when the country was isolated from the rest of the world, the country is used, ruled by the Tokugawa dynasty. When people think samurai era of Japan, the Edo period is usually what they're thinking of. That makes a lot of sense, because they do a lot of samurai-type stuff. Generally with just, like, kendo sticks and all that. But, nonetheless, Tai has a lot of different meanings in this context. I think it means core, as in corporation or group. So, samurai group. There you go. That sounds like that's what that's supposed to be. A group of asshole samurai. All right, set that up there. We'll throw that up here. Might actually throw this even a little bit further back. There you go. It's a samurai chat. Oh my god. Let me see here. So we have we need to have Kana not be here too. I mean, she's already not here, but we could still have them come out. Oh God, you know what I need to do? All right, I got plenty of time. I could talk about that plus, yeah, I'm just looking at what I have going on here. Asshole Samurai was my nickname in high school. James Mitchell needs to be with Mio Shirai and Azu. In fact, let's do James Mitchell and Azumi, because we never have that one-on-one. So let's have entertainment. Can she work a mic? Probably not. You know what? Fuck it. We're gonna give it to her anyway. She'll do good enough. Mitchell, Azumi, and Azumi sit alone as they deal with Kana and Mio both gone. Mitchell decides, let's see, he can help. We'll just put help. Like, he can actually, he can maybe work with her. And you know what? Maybe this is a blessing in disguise, especially for Azumi, because we can use that to help you out. We'll get you in the same position that we have Kana in. So we can set that right about there. We'll just set that right there. Let me see here. So we need our Evil League of Evil. Our Evil League of Evil and Justice Legion stuff, because shit happened. Boy, did shit happen. All right. Helms of the Creator, Dastardly, and Doc Gallows. Mary Dobson not there because she is at the arena. So Evil League of Evil in their lair. Mary is away for a match as Helmsley and the other two fawn over the gauntlet. Perfect. Now that they have it again, they're going to keep it forever. Success. I say minor successes here. It's mostly Helmsley's doing. All right, let's do this. This is going to go badly for the other two, but let me see. No, she's fine. Doc, he could use a little bit. All right. We'll put that up here. And we have the Justice Legion. So we have Lufisto, Mary Dobson, and Carl Anderson. Justice Legion have arranged a funeral for the fallen Captain Charisma. After discussion, they decide to call him. They decide, actually, they must call him. Probably a good 6 minutes. How long could you do that? Let's do seven minutes to put over the funeral, put over how all this has gone down, and then Captain Charisma has been laid to rest. There's only one thing to do, and that's call him. They must contact him, for he is their final option. I really need to make a video for it. This is one of those times I need to make a video for it. I need to get off my ass and do that within the next week. I actually should end with that, because that's where you. Let's see here. Yeah, we'll end with that. This is not going to be the greatest of shows, but let's see here. We got 14 minutes. We need to continue this Kevin, Kylie, Kaylee Ray thing. That's what I need to do here. So, Kylie and Kaylee Ray are in the back looking over free agents. Some names are discussed on bringing to 2K. I'll just put 2K. So maybe about 4 minutes there. They're discussing it, discussing the future of 2K Enterprises and what they'll do. We should put it maybe somewhere in here. We'll put it there. Still got about 10 minutes if I want to do something. Let me see. Is there things I've missed? There's got to be things I've missed. Kangaroo Jess. Oh yeah, I didn't have her there. Oh, that right. Hang on. That's right. She wasn't actually gone for that match, so she could be a part of that. So yeah, Io Shirai is going to be gone. Kairi Hojo. Oh god, okay. Eagles and Matthews should probably have a spot somewhere. Candace. All right, we can have Candace there. Let's see. Let's do Mick Foley in with Candace and Hikaru Shida. And we'll have, I'm trying to think here. All right. Foley has been talking to Shida, who is in the qualifier. Lorray comes in and Foley wants to give her give chance. Oh god. Wants to give chance. Ah, good enough. Fuck it. Good enough. So I guess decent success there between them, since they know that they're going to have qualifying matchups. And we'll put this maybe back here. Yeah, we'll do that. And I think I'm just a... Why did I put 080 tie, by the way? It's 080 tie. Whoops. God damn. Am I just a mess today? I don't know why. We need to do Kairi Hojo. We can probably leave them off. So maybe Kairi and Kaho? We can introduce Kaho with the last 5 minutes? Don't know what, but we'll do it. Let's see. Kairi Hojo, Kaho Kobayashi. Well, time to pitch more stupid shit. Let's do the... Oh, fuck. This is... I don't know how well this is going to go. I might be running a... you know what? Let's do a minor. That's how you get around that one. Do a little bit of a minor one. It's time to pitch stupid shit that I... that I am pretty much done with now. Let's see. Kairi backstage. Whoops. Kaho. Let's see. Intros herself to her. And hopes one day she will reach the same heights as Kairi. Ah! There. Screw it. 5 minutes? Sure, why not? Maybe not 5 minutes. Let's do like 3 minutes, because it's minor anyway, so who gives a shit? I'll just throw that in there, and then maybe I could do like one last thing for like 2 minutes. You know what I could do? I could run. This is what I'm going to run. To help keep people, like, there. It's like, you know they're there. So off screen, overness and overness. Her heights aren't much to aspire for. She's only, what, 5'1"? I think she's like 5'3". That's not that bad. I mean, one of my longest reigning women's champion is Dash Chisako, and Dash is like a legit 4'11". She might be 5 foot, but I'm pretty sure she's closer to 4'11". She is small. But then again, kayfabe's the funny thing about that. I watched a match where she faced... I don't remember who she faced. I think it was in Britain. I just watched the match. Jordan Grace. 4 months ago, she faced Jordan Grace. Jordan Grace is a fucking hoss. That's her whole gimmick, is she's a goddamn hoss. And she lost to fucking Dash. So, yeah. Dash and Jordan Grace. Yeah, one's Amazonian and thick as hell, and one's tiny and thick as hell. I'm just gonna leave it at that. Let's see. Video plays showing the battle. Io and Kana went through at Final Fight. There you go. Sounds like a grave here you're missing. That's probably a thing, though. You know what? That might be the ending of it. We'll do that. That's how we'll end it. We'll end it strong with that. So it's like, we gotta call him. Bum, bum, bum. And then, like, the 2 minutes there of, like, hey, I know it doesn't actually happen. Maybe, hey, reorder the pay-per-view. I wish that could be a thing that you could do, is like a little bit of extra money on pay-per-view replays. That'd be nice. I could see why it would probably be a little pricey. I'd see a little too much to try to do it, but you never know. Oh God, I didn't even put more than a minute on this. Oh God, okay, 3 minutes. I'm going to knock 2 minutes off of something. Let's knock a minute off of this. Yeah, stay pissed. And let's do a minute off of this. And there you go. 125. Boom and boom. Here we go. And here is Breakout. Mercedes Martinez opening it up against Evil League of Evil's Mary Dobson. Beat her in just under 12 minutes with a cop killer. Showing off her skills. Jesus Christ, look at them. Yeah, they really didn't click, did they? Oofa. Well, Mercedes Martinez gets the win in her rise up towards facing Io Shirai in just 9 days. Mercedes hits the cop killer again on Mary Dobson, which goes over much better, and basically looks towards the camera and sends that message to Io. That cop killer was a message sent to Io for Infamous, that if she is in good enough shape, that same thing will happen to her. We go to the back. Helmsley, the creator, with Dastardly and Doc Gallows without Mary Dobson there. Of course, she just got the fucking cop killed. They're in their lair. Mary's away for a match. They don't know how that went. They don't give a shit. But Helmsley, the creator, he has the gauntlet in his hand. He's holding it like a fist and casually stroking it like as if it's a cat. And it's the Precious. As Dastardly and Doc Gallows also pretty much have their faces pressed up against it, as they are just in awe over the gauntlet, as Helmsley sits in his throne, stroking the gauntlet, thinking of his next move, as Dastardly and Doc Gallows also fawn over it and look towards the future. There we go. Mick Foley coming out and deciding that at the end of the month is Dead Storm Rising. the next edition of Dead Storm Rising coming out, and they need. He's decided that no matter what happens in the Io Shirai Mercedes Martinez match, you never know what it might be it with Kana. He's heard some things about both Io and Kana potentially not being around, so he decides that he needs to have something for a number one contender. And if the champion can't make her scheduled title appearances, perhaps an interim champion. Nonetheless, he wants a sudden death fatal four-way at Deadstorm Rising. We're going to find out at least one of the competitors tonight and over the next few weeks determine the next competitors for this four-way. But first, we have a tag team matchup. The women's tag team champions, the Reinas, facing Idol Fight. Decent enough match as Hamada and sort of Nakajima carry the other two. I mean, they just need the experience to really get up and in there. I think it'll get better. Nonetheless, Reinas get the win over Idol Fight. Hamada gets the win there. And, you know, they kind of get back from the cheating ways of the Revolution. Speaking of which, Brittany Knight and Becky Knox are out. And they have come. They want their tag team title match. They beat them last week, sort of, in a six-person. They did some cheating, but nonetheless, they won. Of course, they're blind to the fact that they cheated at all, and when that's brought up, they have no idea what they're talking about. But all they know is they desperately want, maybe not desperately, but they feel that they have earned their tag team title. Yeah, where's my title shot? Oh, it even works with Brittany Knight, too. Where's my title shot? So yeah, they want their tag team title match. Against their bizarre against the Reinas, and we'll leave it at that. Mick Foley in his office isn't really dealing with that right now, but instead has been talking to Hikaru Shida, who he feels is worth, maybe not worth, but he feels is a perfect candidate to have a shot at the women's title. Of course, she was in a Women's Opportunity Trophy winner. She's done very well for herself and decided that she is going to have a qualifier. In fact, as he mentions it, because I'm going to forget if I don't put it in here, a qualifier match, Hikaru Shida against who we're going to find out about later. She'll talk about it against Leva Bates. They have poor chemistry. Fuck it. Yep. Nope. spot in the four-way qualifier. Boom. Next week, Hikaru Shida and Leva Bates in a match that no one really wants again. Headbutt the do girls bleed and break out. I want to see Paige pull and Nigel McGuinness headbutt the turnbuckle. Jesus. And talks to Candice LeRae. And Candice LeRae will actually also have a qualifying match in the future. He hasn't quite determined who she's going to face, but Candice LeRae, nonetheless, will be given a shot. He believes in Candice. He feels like, you know what, this is a new year. 2019 was a rough year, and you know, you made it your New Year's resolution, because I think I talked about that with Candice. I thought I did a promo with that. Maybe I didn't, but either way, Candice has never won a match. She's trying to turn over a new leaf, and Mick Foley wants to help with that. So, you know, on the other side, if she can actually win, everyone should hate her. It's a slightly good point. But either way, he feels that potential within Candice LeRae and wants to give her a qualifying match in the future against who he hasn't decided. I know. I feel like it is one of those things that I'm probably... This is... Yeah, I was just going to say the whole roster. I was just going to say this is the Becky thing. Candice LeRae is getting the Charlotte treatment. But we go out here. Heyman is out with Mayu Iwatani and Miyu Yamashita. Says that Io is still recovering. She'll probably be out next week as well, but she'll be ready for Infamous. She's just gonna have a couple weeks to deal with the damage that she has had against her at Final Fight. But she should be set and ready to go for Infamous and her title match against Mercedes Martinez. Meanwhile. We have Mayu potentially in a match and kind of puts over Mayu and Miyu. Says in the meantime, of course, he's trying to work with Mick Foley. And he says that perhaps he's talked both. He's perhaps talked Mick Foley into having both Mayu and Miyu in this Fatal 4-Way qualifier. So we'll see what happens there. Sisters have entirely opposite personalities. But he's been talking to Foley, and he's working to try to get both of them in this qualifying match. And no matter what, keep the title with Heyman International. Kairi Hojo. Oh, man. I put that shit right in the middle of it. Why did I do that like a dumbass? I should have done this before the other one. Because it doesn't make sense now. Kairi Hojo is backstage. She's, kind of being congratulated a little bit. Hey, Sean, what's up? And she's just in the back, not really doing anything. She's not really in her wrestling gear or anything. She doesn't have to wrestle. But, oh, shit, I forgot. I forgot that because she's brand new, she doesn't do English. But nonetheless, Kaho Kobayashi debuts. And Kyle's just a fan of hers, wishes her luck tonight, yeah. And so, Kairi's sitting around. Kaho congratulates her on winning the Royal Riot. She said after Kairi won the Royal Riot, she had to make sure that she got here and tell her, you know, they've... I don't know if they've ever actually wrestled each other. You know, it's one of those things that you're never 100% sure because it's like, it's Japan, they're Joshis. You kind of have a feeling like they probably faced each other. You just never know. I would love to see like a cage match for that. I'm not sure. let me see. How am I doing? I'm doing pretty good. I'm doing okay. I'm totally looking this up, by the way. I just want to look this up real quick. I'm just gonna. Oh my god, I can't type today. I'm just gonna put Kaho. Nothing. According to Cage Match, they have never once faced each other. But Kaho is a big fan of Kairi and the success that she has had, especially since coming to America. She herself has come to America to find that success as well. Mayu and Miyu are still out there for some unknown reason. Maybe that appeared on the screen. Just dumb. So they haven't. So they're maybe getting ready for a match. Maybe that's why. It's the commercial break thing. Yeah, that's what it is there. It's a commercial break deal. And as it looks like she's getting ready for a match, Oedo Tai's music hits. And Miyu's a little bit confused. Mayu looks like she just shit her pants. Because Oedo Tai's music is the bane of Mayu Iwatani's existence. So she is very unhappy right now. And Kagetsu and Hazuki have popped up from behind them. And they're just looking into the camera. Music hits. And Kagetsu and Hazuki from behind attack them. And beat them down with kendo sticks. You gotta be shitting me, right? What I'm guessing, the way I would imagine it is the idea of Hunter Hearst Helmsley when they announced like Cactus Jack. So like Cactus Jack is announced, his music is getting hit, and like Helmsley is just beside himself. You gotta be Yama shitting me. God damn it. Ah, fuck. Oedo Tai, the assholes versus Heyman Hit Squad, kind of assholes. I'd say Heyman Hit Squad are the, it's the good assholes, the anti-hero assholes versus the villain assholes. They're both assholes. It's just, you know, I guess one's slightly better than the other. I'm going away from that. That leads to Kagetsu versus Mayu. Okay. I can fucks with a 58. They're your favorite duo, the Hyman Hit Squad. Just a pair of cherries. Wow. Coming up next from Japan, I'll be signing Cherry. I would actually... There is a Joshi named Cherry that I could sign. And then I'll hunt down the former WWE Diva Cherry. And there you go. I don't need to know about cherries popping in my mouth. Oh, now I want to call them the Jolly Ranchers. That one's if people who understand the joke are fucking dry heaving right now. The Jolly Ranchers, they'll pop in your mouth. Oof. Either way. She was an outcast of the family because they're all lawyers and shit. He died the fuck off. Of course, she's a wrestler. They're all lawyers. So either way, just under 15 minutes and with a surprise roll-up. Oh, God, I shouldn't have done a roll-up. Well, actually, that makes sense. Kagetsu gets the win over Mayu Iwatani. And Hazuki came in to attack her. I really should have made it tainted, because that really would have... But that wouldn't have put Kagetsu over as much. Hazuki came in and kind of interfered. Mayu still kind of was getting the better of Kagetsu until a roll-up by Kagetsu gets the win. And there you go. Kagetsu and Hazuki have debuted as Oedo Tai. And they get the win over Mayu. Kevin Kiley is in the back with Kaylee Ray. He's looking over a list of wrestlers. He's got a lot of manila folders. I would say he's maybe sitting at a desk, a big desk, with a lot of manila folders, opening up profiles and bios of people on the breakout roster. Makes you think Megahir holds up. What the fuck? Oh, Jesus. So they're looking over a roster of potential free agents, and Kevin Kiley's the human equivalent of manila folder. Oh no. So they're looking over free agents. They discuss some people that they think would be a good addition to 2K Enterprises. Ultimately, they think they maybe settled on a couple of names, but we'll maybe make some phone calls in the future over the next week to discuss new people coming in to 2K Enterprises. Leva Corp are in their locker room, and they're preparing for their match. Courtney Rush has her qualifying match coming up against Dash Chisako. Leva Bates has hers next week, of course, against Hikaru Shida. So that will be coming up. And so they are preparing for them for that. They get their little pep talks ready as they are ready to go. Get this some good lawyers and protection for attempted lynching of Mayu. I think we have a possible attorney who can join. Oh my God. Oh no. We have an attorney on the roster. That would be perfect for Oedo Tai. Holy shit. Oh boy, I think we just found a spot for a certain somebody. Oh no. Okay. James Mitchell and Izumi are in the back. They're just kind of sitting there awkwardly. There's a bit of space in between them. you know. It just seems kind of awkward. They've never really just had like a one-on-one interaction with each other. You know, they've had a little bit, but it's always been around like Mio and Kana. So it's just kind of odd that it's just the two of them, you know. Kana's recovering. Mio is with Kana, helping her recover. And, you know, after a little bit of small talk, Mitchell seems to have a little bit of gleam in his eye, and he says, you know what, with Kana and Mio both gone, this is the time that he can really prove his teaching and prove his level of teaching that he can do. And he's going to help Izumi because he feels like she's got a lot. She's got a lot of potential. She's very young. She's only like 17 years old. She has the whole world ahead of her to make this happen. And I think he thinks that it would be the best thing to have him mentor her and really, really try to work with her in the future. And perhaps not just further Kana's career, but Izumi's as well. Fat Violent J with a group of slim, meaty thigh girls holding a katana. A weeaboo dream. So we get to our main event. Dash Chisako versus Courtney Rush for the first official spot in the four-way sudden death. The sudden death four-way for the number one contendership. And Dash Chisako getting the win over Courtney Rush. And it takes about 21 minutes, but nonetheless, Dash Chisako getting the win as she will move on to Deadstorm Rising at the end of the month to compete in the Sudden Death 4-Way. We come to the Justice Legion. Oh, no. We come to the Justice Legion. They have they are at a perceived funeral that has been arranged for a fallen Captain Charisma. Of course, they've been dealing with the last week has been pretty rough. So they're going through this very serious funeral, and you know, send there's crying and there's flowers being put on maybe a grave. You know, they're kind of having the discussion. Of course, the assumption is that Captain Charisma was washed out to sea because they never found his body. So they were never able to recover the body and give him a proper burial. Thanks for coming to my TED Talk. I feel like that's the best way to start ending, like, stupid thoughts. All the dumb shower thoughts, that's how you end it. Thanks for coming to my TED Talk. And they have a discussion about Captain Charisma, kind of share some of their stories. And the future of the Justice Legion, especially now that they no longer have... why did... I just realized I put Mary Dobson in this like a dumbass. Why did I do that? I'm a dumbass. It's just supposed to be Lufisto, Kangaroo, Jess, and Carl Anderson. Maybe Mary Dobson showed up. Maybe before she went to the arena for her match, she's just off in the distance, like, mocking them. Or maybe you just see her, and she's kind of, like, watching over it and then leaving to go for her match. That's how we'll do it. This was pre-recorded stuff. So this is what happened before the match. That song in the background sounds like Simple and Clean by Kingdom Hearts. I forget what it is. It's Black Rain by... I'd have to look. It's like, she only has like... The woman who sings that song only has like three songs, and that's one of them. Pick a Mary Dobson, Do Not Allow Entry is crazy, bitch. There you go. That's how she's there. But nonetheless, they have a discussion, and it's brought up that they should perhaps... contact their nuclear option. Their back is against the wall. They are truly, they do not know what will happen as long as Helmsley the creator has the gauntlet. They need to do something about it. And they need the final hope that for the Justice Legion, they need to contact him. And they just sort of keep it vague. They have no idea. The camera, the people don't really know exactly who's being talked about. They don't talk about a specific name. I know that dude really shut up. He's like, "Hey man, do you want to be my friend and play TEW with me?" I thought maybe he'd come by and just like talk about TEW maybe a little bit, but like he came in for like 5 minutes and was like, "Yo, want to play TEW?" It's like, I mean, I'm kind of in the middle of this and I don't really play with other people. And then yeah, he asked a couple more people and was like, "Yeah, I'm gone." He asked like four different people. It's like, it was one of those usernames that I'm like, this is definitely someone who's fairly young. But yeah, that's fine. I mean, that's cool. That's cool with him. He wants to hang out. That's cool. It just seemed weird. Like, I figured he'd at least maybe just like hang out and talk, but then he just like up and left. So I'm like, eh, whatever. Okay. So either way, they talk about him. They leave it vague, and they walk away from the funeral, knowing the signal and the contact that they have to send. And then we end the show with a video playing, showcasing the battle that Io and Kana went through, the insanity of the match that they had at Final Fight. And there you go. I have the name. I don't know if I want to end the video with that. God, I don't know if I should contact him now or later. Oh, I feel like I need to make the video first. I don't know if I should make... Oh, I'm so like... I should have made the video already because I could have played that. But now I'm... Either way, yeah. Showing the video, they went through a final fight, and there you go. 89. I'll take it. Order the pay-per-view replay. Tell us off recording. I can do that. I have a feeling... When I tell you, there's going to be a general feeling of fucking course you are. Of fucking course it's this person. 6.11, Jesus H. Christ. We went from 4.5 million to 4.6 million. Jesus. All right, well, there you go. All right, Mayu is annoyed. So you know what? Here, I knew you were going to be annoyed. It's going to cost me a little bit of money, but I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to give her an extra 10,000. Like, thank you. Oh, now she's just irritated. What? Oh, God. You suck sometimes. All right. She has minor morale. Why is Paul Heyman full of piss and vinegar? Is it because he's got people that he doesn't like around here? Is that the idea? TV Richard's also annoyed. I have no idea why. Whatever. All right. I'm going to move to Monday real quick and end this because it's been 2.5 hours. I didn't mean for it to take this long. Jesus Christ. I guess it's kind of longer because I was dealing with some of the extra stuff, like what happened at the end of the year, as we can see what happened at the end of the year. Why is Heyman still pay per appearance? I think it's mostly because it's cheaper that way. Because I use them about 5 times a month. That might be why. I should really do something about certain people. Sonata is still under an exclusive paper appearance, and I didn't even think about that. I don't know why. I haven't even done that. Oh, Brother Yoshi won the BJW Strong World Heavyweight title. Okay. Let's see. BJW seems like they had a big show. Did it do well? Not really. That's all right. 5 times 2,000 is a dickload compared to like 4K a month. Yeah, I need to see. I think he's definitely not 4K a month. Toriano's touring with House of Hardcore. Danny Matthews, spinal disalignment. Oh, Jesus. Oh, boy, that just, oh, he looks worse for wear after that one. A lot of Noah people being picked up here. Oh, hey, you know what? Good for him. Hopefully he can pick up where he left off, do well, and hopefully kick the pill habit that he has had. Maybe we'll talk to him later on down the road. You know, maybe because usually it's like 6 months or so. So we'll give it like 6 months. Well, I'm just going to shortlist him. We'll check again and see where he's at. Let's be honest. He's going to OD. Wow. That's a hardcore sign. To Billy Corgan re-signing with TNA. Oh, wow. WOBZ TV. Oh, they're doing America TV. Okay. I mean, it looks like it's just regional, but okay. I'm interested to see if maybe getting fired changes his perception and gets him figured out. Uh-oh. Man. You hit the yo weight a little too hard. Check if there's interesting titles you can buy. I mean, there's definitely interesting titles I could buy. I'll look at them after this. I'm just trying to get... I could have had two rotundas on my... Shit. He actually would have been a pretty bomb road agent. 86 psych, 100 respect. He actually would have been a pretty damn good road agent. That's all right. I'm doing good enough as is. Doesn't look like anything in particular. Good to see her still getting some work after she left. Eddie Kingston with House of Hardcore. I think we're good there. Get to Monday. By the NWA title, have someone wear it, pretend to be the world champ. There are NWA titles to buy. That is a potential. I think I've mentioned it before that the NWA was one of those things because I've talked about a potential brand split, and that's kind of why I'm doing the stables thing a little bit harder. Is doing the stables thing. Uh-oh. Late night said to be designed to ease the burden. Uh-oh, Dragon Gate not putting on the best of shows? What is retirement really if you don't seem to be suffering from any major concussions? Let's just go ahead and shortlist that. He doesn't have to be a color guy. You know. Hey, dude, Dragon Gate After Dark sounds like something that would do gangbusters, especially Naked Yamato. Maybe not so much with his like new haircut, but Naked Yamato with his long hair. Oof. Maybe we can get off that. This is what happens when you go for too long. Maybe I'll leave it on that. I think once I get around to posting these, actually, I'll probably post the intro videos for the shows before. So yeah, he got the long hair isn't so long anymore. It's like it's like a little above his shoulders. Like if you remember when Tanahashi got his stupid haircut, that's pretty much what it looks like. Is Tanahashi's stupid haircut when he got his before he permed it. Either way, there you go. I'll just do a little bit of showcasing the videos that I'll put on YouTube probably before this episode goes up anyway on stream. If you're watching this on YouTube, though, thank you very much. Greatly appreciate you coming out. Hope you continue watching because we got a whole new year and some whole new bunch of stuff going on. And I will see you next time.